I remember very painfully, and my involvement was this. I was at MGM. I just signed a new contract, and the blacklist happened. And there was a Writers Guild meeting, and I voted for the new board. The next day, I was called into the office of Marvin Skenk, who was an executive at MGM. And he said, I understand you voted for, and he named a writer, I can't remember the name, but I remember a book he wrote called The Journey of Simon McGeever. And he said, did you vote for him? Now, it was a secret ballot. It didn't occur to me to say, how do you know who I voted for? I said, yeah, I voted for him. And he said, who told you to? And I said, no one told me. I voted because he wrote a good book. He's a good writer. We need good writers on the board of the guild. He said, who told you to vote for him? And I really got angry. And he said, did you go around this studio raising money for the children of the Hollywood 10? And I had. And I don't often lose my temper. But I started screaming at Mr. Skenk. I said, you're absolutely right. Those kids should starve. If their fathers did anything wrong and their fathers are in jail, let the kids go hungry. And I'm yelling, and he said, now calm down. He said, just you think about who told you to vote for this man, and I'll come in tomorrow morning. Well, obviously, I didn't sleep all night, and I went in the morning and said, I want out of my contract. He said, I would leave the studio. I was just so humiliated. And he said, no, he said, I talked to New York, and they said, if you'll sign a statement saying that you're not a communist and haven't been a communist, everything's all right, forget everything else. I said, of course I'll sign, never been a communist. But because I raised money for the children of the Hollywood 10, and because I voted for a writer I believed in, to go through this humiliation, and that was nothing because what happened to the others, going to prison, losing their jobs, their families, that was horrible. Those were terrible, terrible days. I hope they never come back.
Did you have any friends that you were close to that happened to?
Eddie Dimitrik.
Oh, yeah.
We had dinner, and he said, you know, they showed me a communist card in the name of J. Purnell Thomas, who was head of the committee. He said, that's how phony they are. And I was horrified. I said, they did that to you, Eddie, awful. 2 days later, he said, yeah, I'm a communist. Then he named everybody. Mm-hmm. No, I didn't really know anyone who was terribly involved. I think I was younger than most of them, younger than Dalton Trumbo and that wonderful group of writers. It was terrible. Yeah. Dorie Sherry said he would never fire anyone because they thought he was a communist. And then when he took over Metro, he fired somebody. And he asked to meet with the writers at the Guild. And we met with him, and he said, you know, I just wanted you to know that the reason I kept this job, even though I fired, I kept this job, is to protect all of you. And we booed him out of the guild. Yeah, it was terrible.